They are speaking out in solidarity with those who recently gathered the courage to do so. A flash mob was organized by Lebanese women to support others who've been sexually abused and harassed. Dozens have broken their silence in the past few weeks, since the start of the so-called October Revolution. In a society where the victim and not the rapist is condemned, this is a challenge to the norms.
This revolution has given strength to many, many, many women in Lebanon, and it has helped a lot of women speak up, including myself, about all the atrocities that's been happening to us that the government has not been taking into consideration, not even the police.
An anti-establishment movement against the ruling elite has given these women a new platform. Like other Lebanese, they are calling for an end to corruption, unemployment, better living conditions, and an overhaul of the political system.
There are so many discriminatory laws against women. I'm gonna just state the main source of the problem. It's the fact that we have no civil codes for personal status. Basically, there are religious courts that run our affairs.
Lebanon is home to many religious sects whose leaders preside over personal domestic issues, such as marriage and divorce.
Women have played an active and vocal role in the protest movement against their leaders. They have taken part in protests, blocked roads, led reconciliation initiatives by crossing front lines in order to preserve national unity. For many of them, this is their chance to bring down the sectarian political system that human rights groups say make them victims.
Activists say one in every four Lebanese women have been assaulted, yet there are no laws that criminalize sexual abuse and harassment. Women also have little protection from violent partners. Custody of children, more often than not, is granted to fathers, and the list goes on. Bringing about change won't be easy.
The greatest things are achieved in small steps. So I would always encourage to just take that slow, because all we need is patience. If we want a peaceful protest, if we want a peaceful revolution, we're going to have to give it its time.
Women who have been challenging the system for years are no longer alone in calling for a secular state. The uprising may have divided society, but these women believe there is already a new beginning. Zeina, Al Jazeera, Beirut.